Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial of Inkscape tutorial for beginners, today we'll be learning all about the levels of different objects used in Inkscape and how to do multiple tasks on them. Stay tuned. Now in this tutorial, all we are going to do first, we will be knowing about the levels incorporated with different objects in our Inkscape document. First of all, let's create here this box. This is the box one that we have created. And we can see that it practically remembers the last setting here. And another thing, if we look into this flat color option, this is the part that we had skipped, we had missed practically in our last tutorial. This is the flat color option from where we may choose different color properties for our Inkscape document. Like this is the RGB color, and in the same manner, this is the CMYK color that we had discussed in the second video tutorial, perhaps, where we had discussed on the various color schemes related to any kind of graphic software, whether it is vector or raster one. So in this particular case, this is the CMYK color from where we may manipulate the color that we wish to have. So I have changed this color here, but we want to revert back to the last color setting that I used here. So I'll be pressing this Ctrl Z. So we have reverted back to the last color setting here, and in the same manner we can see that this is the wheel, and from this wheel we may change the color properties here. We may use something different color for choosing from this, selecting from this wheel system, and we can see that this is another color here. So I have chosen this color, and in the similar manner we may use the stroke color right over here, as we can see. So this is the stroke color here that we might change into. So all those color, those can be used right over here from this wheel segment, or we may choose any color scheme from this RGB selector or from this CMYK selector. And this is the HSL, which means the hue saturation light here. So there it goes. And we can select anything from here. So these are the separate issues. In the first case, all we had done, we had created this individual rectangle here. In the similar manner, we will be now creating another circle, and we'll be setting some different color to it. For say, I am choosing this red color here. So this is the stroke color that we have shifted into, and this is the red color that we had provided right over here. In the similar manner, I'll be using another star here. I'll be creating another star from this shape, basic shapes, those we had discussed in our last tutorial. And we'll be coloring this into a different one, into a yellow one. So we have practically created three separate objects into our canvas. We can see that in the very first place, we had created this rectangular box. In the second case, we had created this circular element. And in the third case, we had chosen a different shape. This is the star as a polygon here. Now, if we have a look around, we can see that the order these elements are created in the same order, it practically sets themselves up into some different levels. Like we had created this rectangular box in the very first case, so it will be residing at the bottom level. Then we had created this individual sphere, this individual circle here, it is residing on top of this rectangular box in the second case, and in the last case we had created this polygon here, this star shape actually, and we can see that it is residing above each and every rest of these basic shapes, those we have created so far. So this is the way the level practically works. It always remembers the last drawn object on the canvas, and it sets itself accordingly. Now if we wish to put our star element at the bottom of rest of the elements into our canvas, like we are practically wishing that this star, it should be residing below this individual circle and this individual rectangular box. So all we need to do, first of all, select it. Now go to this top panel, and here you can see that lower selection to bottom end. That means if we press this one, we can see that at once this star, it is practically residing at the bottom level of this entire document. It is practically below this circle, and it is then below this entire box. In the next case, all we want that the star element, it should be residing above this individual rectangle box, but it should reside below this circle. In that particular case, in the similar manner, we will be heading on top of the panel residing here, and from here we will be raising the selection. The selection here is practically the star. We want to raise the selection, that means the star element, above this individual rectangular box but below this circle shape. So all we need to do, first of all, let's select it, and we'll be heading towards this raise selection one step. We'll be clicking over it, and we can see that the star is practically now residing over this individual rectangular box but below the circular element, as we can see right over here. So this is the second case. Now if we just duplicate this star element, for say we are first of all selecting this star element and we are pressing this Control D, and now we can see that this duplicated element, this duplicated star object here, it resides above all of these individual objects present into our canvas. Now first of all, let's delete it and let's select this individual circle here, and if we press Control D again, we can see that this circle is practically residing above all of these elements present here, above this rectangular box, above this circle, above this star. So the duplicated or the copied element, it practically surfaces up, its level practically surfaces up, and it always stays over each and every document present into your Inkscape document. Now let's delete it first.